dolls, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm so excited to be back with this lip for you guys. It's a dramatic cut crease with a bold lip. If you guys want to know how I achieved this look, just stay tuned and keep watching. So yeah guys, right now I'm just gonna brush through my brows only because I just need to tame them and they're just all over the place, so just to get them in shape ready for me to apply the product on them. I'm gonna use Freedom. You guys know that I love this product for my brows. It's the gel. I don't ever use pencil, and you guys ask me why don't I use pencil. Just because I don't like it. I think it gives off too much product, and I feel like when I'm using a brush and gel, I just have more control over it. Worry if you mess up on this part as well. You are gonna tidy it up. And when it comes to the front, I don't like to drag the product all the way to the front. I'll just use my brush just to distribute it. And then guys, I'm just gonna use the Vintynellie palette. You guys know that I use this palette all the time for my eyebrows, not only because it's my product, you know. Because the coverage is actually bomb. And using an angle brush, this one's a MAC. I'm gonna list the number below because I actually can't remember the number from the top of my head. And then just using a slightly, like ever so slightly darker colour, just for the top part. And voila guys, then I'm gonna use, I don't even know what this brush is called, but it's just like a little eye buffer brush. I'm just gonna use that brush just to like buff it all out. Like this guys, you can see like a big difference obviously between both brows, but yeah, because I've buffered it down to my eyelids, I find that it's just gonna create a natural primer and base for my eyeshadow, just like that. Just before we move on to the eyeshadow, I'm just gonna use my Real Techniques brush and a little bit of my MAC translucent powder just to set the area, only because when it's so creamy, it's hard to put your eyeshadow on top of it because you find that it leaves this like weird finish sometimes and you don't want that, so just pat it all over like this guys. For this look, I'm gonna be using the OPV eyeshadow palette and it's called Gorgeous. So basically I was on Instagram and I came across OPV and I thought, oh my god, like they're actually in the UK, like why have I not tried their products yet? So I thought, yeah, let me order a few of their eyeshadows and highlighter. And when I ordered it, it came next day and I was very impressed with that, so yeah. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use this eyeshadow right over here just as a base color. And with the product that's already on the lid, I'm gonna drag it forward. And then I'm gonna go in with a slightly darker color. This one over here is like a purpley maroon ready kind of color. I'm just gonna go in with some of that, just because I like how it looks and it fits in well. I need a dark color to fit into the crease, the outer corner. And guys, I always say, well, for me, do you know what? With makeup, it's what works for you. But for me, I would always start with the eyes. Only because I get, some people don't actually get product fallout, but I do. And for that reason, I try to always start with my eyes so that when I do get the product fallout, I can just wipe it off my face as opposed to ruining my foundation. But again, if you don't get product fallout, then you need to teach me, because yeah. Then just go back in with your blending brush and just get those two colors blended in. I want this look to be very dark. I want it to be quite dark. So I'm gonna go in with a little bit of black. Don't need to show you guys what that looks like, because black is the same on all palettes, guys. But yeah, I'm just gonna go in with some of the black directly in the crease. And then again, blend it out. This time, dragging it forward as well, so that it comes forward. Slightly going into the midsection in the corner of your crease. Like this, guys. And then just work it in. Remember, circular motions warm up the product so it diffuses nicely. And as you can see, I'm just switching between my brushes, because blending plays a very, very big part, just to make everything just look so flowy. Just to make everything flow lovely. If you're satisfied, then you're ready for the next step, girl. Using Laying Low by MAC, and it's a paint pot, and just a very small precise eyeshadow brush. I'm gonna go into my cup. I know a lot of you guys use concealers to do your cut and stuff, but I just prefer paint pots. Why? Because I find that the concealer creases, whereas the paint pot, I don't think it creases that much. I was actually looking again at the comments, because that's where I see how you guys really feel about these tutorials. And someone said that they've got like double eyelids. If you've got double eyelids, you would literally go a little bit higher than your actual eyelids. So where it creases and naturally cuts, you would go a little bit higher than that. So I'm just gonna pat it out when I'm coming towards the end, just so that it's gonna like do its own blending with the eyeshadow. I'm gonna do a try and error with you guys, and I'm gonna see how pigmented these OPV glitter eyeshadows are. Well, it looks glittery and sparkly, so I'm gonna see how, you know, how it is, if I need to add glitter or not. So I'm gonna probably try this one, or that one, or that one, or that one, I'm not sure. Oh wow, guys, look, this is not even glitter. Wow, I'm actually really impressed. I'm really, really, really impressed right now. Yeah. So I'm using the first gold on the Gorgeous palette over my cup, just because I found that it looked quite plain and boring when I left it the color of the paint pot. So I'm just gonna add a bit of eyeshadow on top of it, just to make it exciting. Thank you. it still looks like quite a contrast. So I'm not going to use the same gold, I'm going to use a lighter gold towards the end, just to make it look like it's, just to not make it so harsh, like it's sort of disappearing gradually. So just use a lighter gold and then do that at the end, just to not get that harsh line. And then you can let it get onto the black a little bit, because remember, you want it to look faded away a little bit. All right guys, using Black Trap by MAC and a really small angle brush, just gonna dip that in and then start with my eyeliner. So you guys know I like to start on the outside. Oh, you know when your brush does this and the hair starts to separate, that is not even a good look. Okay, cool. I've tried to fix it. Guys, what do you think? Do you think I should do get readies with me? Get readies, you know, get ready with me. Because I feel like this is a get ready with me, but it's actually not, it's just a talk through. But I feel like maybe I should do it. Maybe I should just have catch ups with you guys and just fill you guys in, life updates, you know? Right now, I'm just going in with a liquid liner, because I find it just makes it look extra dark. And there you have it guys, you have your wing. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm actually just gonna move on to my eyelashes, because you guys know that obviously no look is ever complete without lashes. And I'm just going to use my Vintynellie VN Luxe eyelashes. So yeah, I just put the glue on the strip part of my eyelashes, and whilst I leave that to get a little sticky and tacky, I'm just going to put some mascara on. The reason why I do this is because it helps grip onto the fake eyelashes. It should be ready by now. By the way, if you're putting on eyelashes for someone else, never blow it. It's really unhygienic. It's not a good look, but if it's yours, then obviously yes, you can blow it. But if you're like, I don't know, an aspiring makeup artist, just a tip. And then I go over just to make it blend out, just make it look all nice. Just go over it with some eyeliner and look at the difference. This eye looks sick, and then this eye is just looking all fleek. This eye looks very ill and sick. Then I use the reverse side of the tweezer just to push it up. And if you push it up, you can actually see it blends in very well. I push it up just to give it a lift. And these mink lashes, you don't actually need to add mascara to the actual lash, because it's 3D mink, you know, so it's got that volume you're looking for. And there you have it guys, this is one side completed. Once I'm gonna come off camera, do this side for you guys, and then I'm gonna come back just to show you guys how I tidy up my wing, and then we're gonna move on to the face. So guys, I went back to this eye. So when I finished this eye, I went back over here and I just added some white gel eyeshadow base from NYX in the cut, just to make it more defined, because as you can see, you can't really see the cut too clearly on this one. It just looks like a regular application. So yeah, I'm using an angle brush and I just dipped it in, just the tip of it, dipped it in, and just now I'm gonna gently just dab it. Just create the outline first. So now I'm going to show you guys how I tidy up my wing. On this side, the wing is not as sharp, and I was kind of happy that it didn't come out sharp, just so that I could show you guys how I tidy it up. And this area, you're just gonna go over it with foundation anyway in a minute, so it doesn't really matter how it looks. It will be fine. And there you go. The under my eyes, I'm probably gonna smoke it out, but I don't smoke it out just yet. I wait until I've got some of my makeup on just to add some eyeshadow at the bottom. I don't know why I don't like doing it before. So now we're gonna prime the face with Natural Radiance by MAC. I just jot it around my face and I just rub it in. I'm gonna be using a different foundation today than usual. You guys know I love me some Black Opal, but I'm actually gonna be using L'Oreal True Match. I've got two different colors simply for the fact that even though it's called True Match, like, I still haven't found one to truly match my color. I don't know why. Okay guys, so then I mix the two to get my colour, and I'm just gonna apply it with the sponge. Even though this one is a little bit, it's still a little bit dark, it will do, because I'm still gonna highlight. Going back in with the Vintynellie concealer palette, I'm gonna highlight my face with it, and the same color that I used at the top of my brow is the color that I'm gonna use to highlight my face. The one that I use at the bottom is a bit too white, so we're just gonna use the one that I use at the top. You know what guys, I actually don't know why I never used the beauty blender before. It's so good. I remember one of my previous videos, I was like, yeah, I don't like the beauty blender. I feel like it takes away all the product. I guess it just depends which one you use, because yeah, the Disfull Techniques one, it's really nice. And now I'm gonna contour with the Black Opal foundation stick in Black Walnut. Guys, makeup is a lot of work, but you know what, it's worth it. The end result is always worth it. So to set my highlight, I mix what I set it with. So I set it with Sasha Buttercup mixed with MAC Loose Powder, because the Sasha's a little bit too yellow, but I like it, but it's too yellow. So, oh my god, that's a lot of powder, girl. So yeah, I just mix the two. yeah guys, don't be like me, don't be so, it's super messy. If you've got a sponge, use a sponge. I promise you won't get so messy. Look at my nose now from straight on, it looks a little bit slimmer. It looks like it's a lot more defined. Okay guys, so whilst baking, I'm going to do my lips. And I'm actually gonna be using the Kylie lip kit, but the limited edition one, so I don't know if you guys can get it, but it's the holiday edition one from like last month. But first I'm gonna line my lip with Bittersweet. By MAC. Okay guys, so I've lined my lips. This is the holiday edition Kylie lip kit that I'm gonna use. It comes with 6 different colors and I'm going to use, oh guys, I don't know, there's no name on this one. It's just the matte liquid lipstick, so yeah. What do you guys think of this lip colour with this look? I really like it. I think it goes very well for that type of look that we're going for. So next I am going to contour with CoverGirl Queen Collection in Ebony Bronze, I think. Yeah, this one is Ebony Bronze. I'm just gonna go over the hollows of my cheeks. So now guys, I'm just gonna line my waterline with this NYX. It's just the white liner from NYX. I'm gonna line my waterline with it. And that's it. So now the reason, now I'm gonna go in with mascara, but the reason why I'm not gonna put it on now is because mascara is a tricky thing. If you put it on your eyelashes and it's still wet and you try to dust off the residue of your baking, you would find that it can smudge. So to avoid all that smudging stuff, I just do it last when I've dust everything off already. Now the nose looks straight now. And when I dust this part off, you're gonna see how it's really helped. See, so it makes it look really, I went from having like a plumped cherry nose to now having like a really straight bridge, and it's all because of how you highlight and contour. So the trick is to always drag the concealer, remember, always drag the concealer a little bit further out, and then now we dust everything off. So using Raisin by MAC and an angle blusher brush, I'm just gonna put that onto my cheeks. So at this point I'm gonna fix blush everything and now I'm gonna highlight, because I like having my face a little bit wet before I highlight, just so that the pigment really, really comes out. And I'm highlighting with Anastasia Beverly Hills, So Hollywood. And I'm gonna put that on my nose. Oh, this is amazing, guys. Look at it. It's too cute. And I'm not gonna put it all down the bridge, just the top part, like so, and the bottom. I'm gonna put a little bit on the forehead. And then right here, guys, this highlighter is Bay of Life. Look at it. It's got me glowing. Two more things. Mascara on the lower lash line. I'm gonna use my highlighter, the highlighter that I used to do my face. Use that in the inner corner. Oh, yeah, guys, I've done it. And here's the end finish, guys. I hope you guys really, really enjoyed this tutorial. I decided to do a talk through as opposed to a voiceover because I thought I really want to go into details, especially with this kind of cut crease. But I really wanted to feel like I'm engaging with you guys. So if you want more videos like this where I'm talking to you guys whilst doing it, then please let me know. It's something that I'm really, really interested in doing. And also, if you want to see a get ready with me, simply for the fact that I felt like I was really doing like a whole get ready with me kind of thing with you guys, so if you want me to do one of those, then just let me know. But please subscribe, like and comment, and just remember, like, comment what you guys want and you guys might just get it. Thank you guys for tuning in, and just stay tuned for the next video.